Oh, like, what's happening? Has Jose Mourinho ended Pep Guardiola at Manchester City? Which is the first match. I finished 2-0 Spurs. I did predict a win. I'm pretty sure Tottenham Hotspur. I couldn't see. I don't think anyone's seen Man City pick up a result. And I was almost foretold. It was a very typical Jose Mourinho style game. I think they only had 2 shots on target through the entire 90 minutes. Pep's side, they had possession, they had, I think, 7 or 8 shots. But as Man City's been this season, they have been extremely poor with converting their chances. It was a good finish from Son, good ball for top of Ndombele, in behind for Son, one touch, through the legs of Ederson, and running by the edge of the box. 5 minutes in and that was 1-0 Tottenham Hotspur. Just around about the 65th minute, closing in on the 70th, it was Harry Kane picked up the ball, almost in there in his own half, ran about 20-30 yards, played the ball in for Lo Celso for 2-0. It was another good finish for Tottenham Hotspur. Tottenham have now went top of the league. I am filming this on Sunday. The Liverpool and Leicester game is yet to kick off. If Leicester win, they go top. That's the only way that Tottenham did not finish this weekend top of the Premier League. So don't quote me on it then and now. I'm only doing it because I'm filming early. Overall, Tottenham played very well. They definitely, Jose Mourinho has got them playing well. 9 games in, 20 points picked up. They have dropped a load of points. They have dropped a total of 7 points, which you do. It's no good because right now I think after that result yesterday, Tottenham Hotspur are now deservedly in a shout for the title now under Jose Mourinho, which would be ironic if they went on to win it as he was sacked for Manchester United. This result puts extreme pressure on Pep Guardiola after he signed a new 2-year deal. I feel that the 2-year deal was given to Pep as a kind of cover blanket, as if he is shocking this season, they only have to pay him out of another year or two. It's not gonna, I think it states that with a there being only a 2-year deal and not like a 4 or 5 year deal, Man City are definitely considering Pep Guardiola's future at the club. I think overall Pep Guardiola probably, his time is now up at Manchester City. I think if this season Man City fail the challenge for the title again and almost have the same season as last or possibly even worse the way that they're going now, Pep will not be Manchester City boss come next season. Match 2 was Newcastle United versus Chelsea at St James's. I predicted a win for Chelsea. I said 3-1. It was 2-0 Chelsea. Chelsea dominated from start to finish. There was no challenge for Newcastle apart from later on in the second half. It was almost an absolute screamer from about 30 yards from Sean Longstaff. That would have almost just killed off Mendy as it was an absolute thunderbolt. It clipped the crossbar and went over. The first goal was an unfortunate own goal from Fernandes for Newcastle's defender. The Argentine just was claiming that push, but it was a bit blatant that there was no push at all when the ball hit him. And it was unfortunate for the guy, Geezer. Aye, started there. Overall, Chelsea were dominating. Timo Werner, the star striker, definitely had a poor game. Even though he got an assist for Tammy Abraham's goal, I'm sure it was. Ultimately, he had a good few chances that he should have buried. There was one where he could have just struck it, but he chose to take the unselfish option, which, fair enough, he probably shouldn't have done because it was about 12, 13 yards out. Director for a goal, probably should have shot and buried it. This result puts Chelsea second at the current time of recording on the 22nd of November. With this result also for Newcastle, after a very, very poor display, they sit 14th and not looking good under Steve Bruce at the minute. After a couple of good results, they are now dropping off, which is unfortunate for Newcastle. It will be a result that questions the tactics of the team, questions the mentality of the team. Do I think that Newcastle will get relegated? I don't think so. Ultimately, they're still a good team. They've still got very good players in Almiron, Carl Wilson, Saint-Maximin, Dubravka, Jamal Lewis, Ryan Fraser. They've got tons and tons of good players. But ultimately, I don't think that they deserved anything from the weekend's result. The 2-0 probably flattered them. Chelsea probably should have won 4 or 5-0, but Timo Werner couldn't capitalise on his chances. It was ultimately a good result for Chelsea, for Frank Lampard. And we move on to the final match of the three, which was Old Trafford, Manchester United versus West Brom. This was a very poor display from Manchester United. West Brom probably, I would say, deserved at least a point from the game. The penalty that Manchester United got was a penalty. It was a blatant handball. His hands, as he turned, his hands swung out to the side here and hit him. The penalty did have to be retaken, which it definitely should have been. People say it shouldn't have, but ultimately, Sam Johnson, the goalkeeper, the ex-United keeper, came off his line quite blatantly, and it was shown for. Ultimately, United didn't create enough chances. Sam Johnson did have a decent game and goal for West Brom, but you see, with Martial, he should have buried a chance. Rashford probably should have buried a chance. Ultimately, they're now, they have been playing Wan-Mata a bit more recent, as Greenwood has been come under a bit of attack from the press, which is very shocking, I would say, after his best friend has reportedly took his own life, which is never the option. For me personally, it's every hope that Greenwood recovers from it. From situations like this, he does need to take his time. Mentally, when you're down, you need to be careful that you don't overdo it, you don't overthink stuff. And it's unfortunate for the young lad. But going back into the game, as I've said already, it was a very, very poor performance for Manchester United. West Brom should have received something from the game. The win does move United up to 9th place in the Premier League table. It does help Ole Gunnar Solskjaer, but also the performance was not there, even though the result was with a clean sheet. I don't think that this helps Ole much. It helps him slightly with the result, but the performance needs to be there consistently. I think with that, I've talked enough about all three matches. All three matches only roughly get about 3 minutes, 3-4 minutes. This has been pre-recorded on the Sunday due to my work commitment on Monday. At the time of recording, Liverpool and Leicester City are yet to kick off. If Leicester win, they will go top. Tottenham go down to second, Chelsea third. I don't know how the result will go later the night. I do think Leicester will win away at Anfield, but need to wait and see. There is a link in the description for the official Twitter account. If you go over there and drop us a follow, that'll be very much appreciated. If you drop a like on the video, that'll help more than you think. Sharing with your friends, family, everyone possible, that pushes us out to many, many more people. If you subscribe to the channel, that shows that all this work is definitely going well. There is also a link for your very own FIFA Ultimate Team cards, ranging from back in FIFA 11, I'm told, up to the new one, FIFA 21. Use our link in the description for the official Twitter account of Future Cards, and you'll see we sent you, and you will get 30% off your first order and also free shipping if you're within the United Kingdom. But with that, hope you had a good week. Hope you had a good weekend. But with that, catch you for Friday's episodes. With that, catch you all later. See you on Friday. And peace.